You can only succeed in closing the church temporarily. But the people you think they will follow you, they will escort you.
Yeah. And when they reach a place they want,
they leave you there.
Yeah, and that's right. They go. That's right.
They go. You look around and discover you are empty.
Yeah.
May God help us.
Amen.
I say this again. Please, child of God, I beg of you in the name of what you believe. In the name of whatever you believe, never you talk down on anybody.
Amen.
It will not help you.
Amen.
It will not help you.
Never.
People are waiting to manifest this year.
Yes,
people
yes,
are struggling to manifest. Yes. People are believing that they will get married and they are not married. Do you know it's not normal? Somebody somewhere have spoiled things for somebody.
Yes.
But I want to tell you this, if I be a man of God, which I know I am,
yeah,
I'm standing on this altar, on this ground, and I say, oh God, anything that will stop people's manifestation, let it be destroyed today in the name of Jesus
Christ.
You are waiting for your manifestation. You are waiting, patiently waiting. Your manifestation.
Amen.
And I want to tell you, you will manifest your house.
Yes,
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 yes, yes. You will manifest your family.
Amen.
I don't know whom I'm talking to.
Amen.
The 27 people that will drop money on the altar, I'm talking to you. You will manifest your car this year. You will manifest your house this year. You will manifest every good thing in your life this year. No power will stop your manifestation. If I be a man of God, which I know I am, there will be a strong manifestation. Your destiny and your success. Rabagadayagada. Refute Rabagada. This is a manifestation time. It's a manifestation time. I'm telling you something. Some of us, we are sick and the sickness refuses to go.
Yeah.
You think it's normal?
No,
it's not normal.
No.
I want you to do two things. Number one, ask yourself a question. Why?
Why?
Because you need to ask why. If you're in this branch or you're in this ministry, we have three altars that work in three different things.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
There are some time you can go into the angel's garden there and spend like 2 hours inside there. Talk to God. Say, give me a cloud of favor.
Amen.
That when I walk out here, people will favor me.
Amen.
Give me that cloud. You enter there and lie down. Watch it and see. We have given you all spiritual things that will help you in manifestation.
Amen.
But the problem we have is that we are too religious. And we are not spiritual.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus.
We are too religious. But not what?
Spiritual.
The time we start being spiritual, we will start valuing spiritual things.
Amen.
Amen.
Can I talk?
Talk.
Stop craftiness.
Amen.
Read that last place again.
But have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty.
He said, renounce hidden things.
Of dishonesty.
Wait, let me come here. Just be reading me like a Christian, not like a Muslim. Reading like a Christian, not like a Muslim. Lie, who they lie, Muslim.
No, lie.
No, really like a Christian. Now, there are things hidden in you that I can't even come and tell, even if I know it, I'm not in you. Because it cannot. It doesn't, how do I put it? I don't feel it's necessary.
Yes.
If I come here and say, hey, your name is Chris, Margaret. Margaret, you are just coming from your boyfriend's house in Palaseco. That is where you sleep for 2 days. Does it make sense?
No, it doesn't help you in any way.
Does it make, take you to heaven?
No.
Rather, that is an embarrassment.
Yeah.
I want happened to some of you?
Yes.
That's an embarrassment.
Yes.
But there are hidden things that Jesus says you need to confess it.
Yes.
Confess your sin to one another. It's not a drill gun. No. That cannot exist here. Don't do it. I put it to you. Don't do it.
Trouble.
No, don't do it. But this is it. There are things you need to talk to God. But in this country, every time I want to, I'm needing somebody to talk to, you know, this thing is really paining my heart. I need to talk to somebody. Must you talk to somebody? Can't you talk to God?
Talk to God.
Yes.
It's only in this country that I see people, they want to talk to somebody. They want to talk to somebody. They want, for what? Take it out of your chest.
We want to get it off your chest, prophet.
You want to get it out of your chest?
Yeah,
who take it there? Who put it there?
Take it out.
Who put it there? Tell the person that put it there to take it out.
Yes.
But sometimes, listen, we need to hidden things in our life.
Amen.
There are some hidden characters you have.
Yes.
Hidden attitude.
Yes.
Yes.
There are some of us, we are too religious, but when we talk, we offend people.
Yeah.
It's a spirit. Deal with it.
Amen. Deal with
Amen.
It.
Amen. Amen.
Deal with it.
Yes.
And try to take correction.
Yes. Amen.
You are a leader. They correct you.
Yes.
You refuse. We throw you out of the boat.
Bye-bye. Yeah.
You know that song they say? So long, bye-bye. When we throw you, we put that song for you. Bye-bye.
Oh, bye-bye.
Am I telling somebody?
Yes.
Tell me bye-bye. Go and start your own ministry.
Bye-bye.
We can even ordain you immediately and say, go and start your ministry.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Your own.
Amen.
Amen.
If you don't have a name, we can borrow you a name. If your name is Christian, we can say Christian Pentecostal Church.
Yes.
It's your own. Go and start it.
Hey.
Because it's time for us to manifest love.
Amen.
Care.
Yes.
Unity.
Yes.
The Bible says, for this man we know that you belong to him.
Amen.
People, we know you belong to Jesus. Hidden things,
Jesus.
Do away with them. Go ahead.
Dishonesty.
Now, he now comes to dishonesty.
Yes.
Do you know, let me share this testimony just out of point. I have a business. I spend money so much on that business for security. To hire personal securities and all that, paying police. Because, not because for the police to protect the money from armed robbers. No, for police to protect the money from the workers. Going to put it in the bank, they will tell us, I'm going, one person just come. That's it. They will pretend that somebody robbed them. Some can even take something and
beat themselves.
You are talking beat. Oh, beat, take knife.
And cut themselves.
And bleeding, you can't do anything. So I hire police. So if you are going to put the money in the bank, police go.
Yeah.
And sometimes when I try to talk to the bank to come and take the little money, you understand?
Yeah.
Even in the church in Nigeria, if before church finish, the bank is already in the church to collect the money in our crusade and go. Because if you leave the workers to count and all that, they will tell you, I'm robbers, come there. So you don't trust them.
Hey, my word.
That's the kind of lie. So, and we continue like that. Until I, and some of them can have good certificate. Accountant, master degree in accountant. All they qualify is to add figures and minus your figures and take your money. So, and a lot of people in the church was working for me, a lot. So, and they are the most horrible people to deal with. You know, these Pentecostal people that believe that God forgives, they are the worst people to deal with. But they don't know that they are putting hot oil and fire upon themselves.
Yes.
And finally, I guess somebody is not a Christian, he's not even a Muslim, I think he's a Buddhist.
A Buddhist? Yes.
Yeah, to manage that business. I just give it to him and make him a manager. I remove the person that's Pentecostal thinking. PhD. I remove him and he was not happy. He left the house, a lot of things. But I need to put the business in order.
Yeah.
This guy entered here and turned the place around.
Amen. Amen.
Not a Christian. He doesn't believe in your Jesus. He just a Buddhist.
Yeah.
I don't even know what they believe in.
Yeah.
I just know he's a Buddhist.
Hey.
He's a Buddha. He worship Buddha or whatever. I don't know about the religion. When I went to employ him, people were like, why are you bringing unbeliever to that company? That company will close. I said, let the unbeliever come. Let's watch Satan and angels. Then when we bring this Satan,
yes.
Company change.
Amen.
Do you know I can sleep with my two eyes closed?
Yes.
The guy removed all the security, police, and do you know that we put CCTV on necessary things? And I put it on my phone every time I'm looking at my phone and looking at the company to see who is ticking and who is running. After that, I never employ people based on certificate.
Amen.
I employ people based on honesty.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Because that Buddha man was as honest as anything.
Amen.
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 And the company turned around.
Amen.
We no longer pay security. A lot of things we no longer do. This unnecessary channel of removing my small money.
Yeah.
Yes. We gather it back.
Amen.
The only thing that the man, even his salary is even more cheaper than the PhD ticket.
Yes.
PhD Christian. His salary was cheaper. And when the guy came into office, he discovered a lot of lapses and money.